Hello, Luke here. In this video, we will install Ansible and the Kerberos packages on a Red Hat Enterprise Linux machine, and then we'll use an Ansible playbook to connect to a Windows Server 2022 machine and install the ISCSI target server feature. So let's go ahead and switch over to my machine and we'll get started. So our first step is we need to spin up a Red Hat Enterprise Linux machine, and I'll just do that by running vagrant up. That machine's name will be RHEL1 or RHEL1. And as you see, SRV1 and DC1 are on a domain, a Windows domain named homelab.local. And then while that's starting up, let's go ahead and switch over and take a look at our host file or inventory file that we'll be using for this demo. We'll be focused on the storage servers group, which right now it only has SRV1 in that group. And then you can see the connection variables here. We are using WinRM. We're ignoring the cert validation because in the sandbox, we're using a self-signed certificate. Ansible port is 4986. We are using Kerberos as the WinRM transport versus ntlm. And then we've got a few timeout settings. So let's go ahead and switch back to VMware workstation. All right, should RHEL 1 has started up. So we're going to go ahead and just use Vagrant SSH to connect. And this machine is already associated with my Red Hat developer subscription, so there's no need to go ahead and register it again. We do that with the Vagrant file. So let's go ahead and run Python 3.11. And we're going to use the pip module to install Ansible. Python 3.11 is already installed on this machine, but I'll include all of the commands that we run in the blog post that's associated with this video. And real quick, if you're interested in setting up your own virtual sandbox, I do have a free three-step guide to get you started, and I'll place the link for that guide below as well. So Ansible has installed. Let's go ahead and install ansible-lint. And the next step is we need the WinRM package for Python, since we're connecting to Windows. Before I proceed and install the Kerberos components, I want to show you the error that you may receive if you haven't done that yet, and you've tried to use Ansible to connect to a Windows machine using Kerberos. ntlm, you don't have an issue, but Kerberos requires a few more packages because it is a bit more secure than ntlm. So let's go ahead and change the directory to the folder that's currently hosting our playbooks. So the command we're going to use is ansible playbook. The inventory file we're going to use is the host.ini, and then we're going to use the playbook win iscsi. YML file, and then we're going to provide a user that's going to be the administrator user inside the homelab.local domain, and we're going to just prompt for the password. So you'll get this message stating that the machine is unreachable. because Kerberos, the Python Kerberos library is not installed. So let's go ahead and install that library. We have to install a few other packages before we do that. Now we have one more step before we run our playbook again, and that's to install the Kerberos package. And let's take a look at the playbook that we're going to run. Its target is the storage servers group, and we're going to run two tasks. We're going to use the Windows win underscore feature module to install the ISCSI target server, include the management tools. We're going to make sure the state is present. We're going to register any changes to ISCSI, and then if ISCSI changed, we're going to go ahead and call this task to reboot the server. Let's go ahead and switch back over our terminal window and run that playbook. This time we didn't receive the Kerberos error, and now Ansible is running the playbook. SRB1 should be restarting here in just a moment. SRB1 has finished restarting. We can see that our play recap was successful. Ansible made two changes. That was installing the ISCSI target feature and then rebooting SRB1. Let's go take a look to make sure that that feature is now enabled. And we do that by going into Server Manager, going up to Manage, Remove Roles and Features, click Next again. And here under Server Roles, expand File and Storage Services, and then expand File and iSCSI Services, and you should see iSCSI Target Server is enabled. At that point, you can go ahead and cancel out. I plan to use this server in my sandbox environment as a storage server for a few Windows failover clusters that I plan to build. So that's it. If you found this video useful, I'll go ahead and just like and subscribe. I will be having additional videos around automation and setting up your own sandbox and also a SQL Server. Again, that free guide is available below. If you're looking to get started with your own virtual sandbox, be sure to check that out. Thanks a lot.